How are you holding up?
Not in any mood to talk about it.
Your fish stinks of the void. What kind of rat would sell such filth?
The kind that don't fancy starving, along with the rest of this town.
It's all well and good for you with your rations. We've got to take what we can get.
Back for a return visit, are you?
Keeping it together,
from a cell floor.
I'm all right, as long as I don't think about it too much.
You're safe among friends. Never forget it. Keeping it together, Bree.
I'm all right, as long as I don't think about it too much.
You're safe among friends. Never forget it.
Have at it.
It together, Bree.
I'm all right, as long as I don't think about it too much.
You're safe among friends. Never forget it. Smells worse over here than a dozen rotten eggs dropped in a vat of vinegar.
Then don't come over. Not like you're buying anything.
I don't come visit your tongue. Who will?
Wouldn't you like to know?
Keeping it together, Bree.
I'm all right, as long as I don't think about it too much.
You're safe among friends. Never forget it. Keeping it together, Bree.
I'm all right, as long as I don't think about it too much.
You're safe among friends. Never forget it. smells worse over here than a dozen rotten eggs dropped in a vat of vinegar.
Then don't come over. Not like you're buying anything.
If I don't come visit you, Tun, who will?
Wouldn't you like to know?
Keeping it together, Bree.
I'm all right, as long as I don't think about it too much.
You're safe among friends. Never forget it.
Got yourself situated.
Yep, yep.
If you anything that will protect against food, Mike.
I can turn aside fire, cold and poison. But wide walking, God knows what'd stop those beasts.
Cold stealing.
Keeping it together, Bree.
I'm all right, as long as I don't think about it too much.
You're safe among friends. Never forget it. Smells worse over here than a dozen rotten eggs dropped in a vat of vinegar.
Then don't come over. Not like you're buying anything.
If I don't come visit you, Tun.
Well met, friend. Interested in...
You look down at the cart and see fish with flaking scales, tumours, and, in one case...
Have it your way, mate.
You're safe among friends. Never forget it.
Glad to see you well.
Smells worse over here than a dozen rotten eggs dropped in a vat of vinegar.
Then don't come over. Not like you're buying anything.
If I don't come visit you, Tun, who will?
Wouldn't you like to know?
Until later, then.
Keeping it together, Bree.
I'm all right, as long as I don't think about it too much.
You're safe among friends. Never forget it. Keeping it together, Bree?
I'm all right, as long as I don't think about it too much.
You're safe among friends. Never forget it.
Tell me, have you heard any news?
Nothing good. The Void Woken are everywhere. Thank the Divine you're here to protect us.
Yes, of course.
What? I have nothing less than the wisdom of the ancients.
Safe among friends. Never forget. once. Never forget it.
Glad to see you well. Until later, then.
For insubordination!
Keep your eyes peeled, would you? Ramos the Wanderer promised he'd be here.
Wait, my friend!
If you got nothing to hide, you got nothing to
An elf sways on her chair, her eyes focused on the counter in front of her, where she has six glasses in a row. With the nails of two fingers, she's pressing red welts into her forearm. She slides one of the drinks towards you, her head bobbling heavily on her neck as she nods at the sparkling ale.
And that's... Drink or shut up. Nothing like a glass of the good stuff to smudge everything into a pretty shape.
She slides another glass of ale toward you. Its contents sparkle in the dim bar light.
Bottoms up. Can you just not? Cheers to you, me, and...
Her gaze swivels around the room.
Damien's dull knife. This place is horrible. Another. What do you mean? These are... changing times or whatever.
She raises a glass and glances at yours on the bar.
To changing times. Come on. Last one for the road. Ah, down the old ouch. Reckon that was. And another thing. Let me tell you something. And another thing. Real of the good stuff. And another. Stew is people and people is stew.
My friend, or Alexander the Innocent.
A prim woman in a starched apron wipes a glass with a clean rag. She pins...
Blessings upon our Lucian, seven times divine.
Menu simple. Eat or drink.
Hold it. Papa no-no, you no-go.
He grins, unpleasantly.
Loha didn't tell me to let anyone of your description in. So why should I? Nice try, Jimmy Suave, but you're really not my type. You again? I told you to scram once. Don't make me say it with my fists. You can't buy my friendship. But you can buy 10 seconds of me eyeballs examining the ground for, well, let's say, a small fortune. You look like you'd be good for it.
Yeah.
He pockets the coin and gazes dramatically at the ground, mere inches from your feet.
Spotted something.
Look at that. A fresh face. And a pretty little kisser it is, too. Welcome, Bee Governor. Take a load off and enjoy Effie's plunder down under. Good to meet you, Governor. What's your poison, then? A sip or a smoke? Aye, so it is. But not just any druid, nay. Oh, no. My own special blends. Further down's the arena, see? And the gladiators are always on the lookout for an edge. I give them that edge. You could say that my darling herbs flower in the flesh and blossom in the brain. So, if you're interested, Governor, all you have to do is use your imagination. How can I make you bloom? No problem. In return for a reasonable donation, that is.
Effie digs all kinds of outlandish herbs from out of the depths of many pockets and mixes them with the patience and skill of an alchemist.
Much obliged, Governor. And here's your blend. Just take it to that big beauty of a pipe over there and have a blast.
Smoke billows from this strange contraption. It's adorned with hoses, levers, and slots.
Seven, save me! This leaf is strong!
this again.
Gods, is there a void woken down there?
Who in their right mind would keep a... Must be one strong force field keeping it inside.
Down for a little scuffling and tussling. Let's see if you got some fight in you. down for a little scuffling and tussling. Let's see if you got some fight in you. Down for a little scuffling and tussling. Let's see if you got some fight in you. down for a little scuffling and tussling. Let's see if you got some fight in you. Figure it's time to prove yourself. Let's get it done. That's the spirit. But I've got to tell you, you probably want to see Murga around the corner before you draw blood. She's the champion, and she's fair particular about who she'll fight. She'll want to talk with you herself before she'll assent to any challenge. Watch your words, mind. She takes against you, there'll be no talking yourself into her good graces again. Well, you better start caring. Without her approval, you'll be stuck spectating. On your way, then.
In the shadows, a dwarven woman spits obscenities down upon a caged Voidwoken. She exudes a powerful air of menace and an even more powerful odor of old sweat and dried blood. She spies you and glowers.
More fodder for the arena. Let Murga the champion test how good your reflexes are.
Curling her torn lip back over broken teeth, she grabs your hand and pulls you down to the ale-soaked table. Never losing eye contact, she begins arm wrestling you. She glimmers in and out of view, merging with the shadows. Crowing, she slams your hand down into the table, hard enough to draw blood.
You need to practice more, dear. Try some pull-ups before you even think about going one-on-one with me. I bested that Voidwoken below us, you know. Dragged that scaly lump down there with my own two hands. So, since you can't hope to beat me, what is it you want down here? Based on your performance so far, that's cute. But I shouldn't judge your baby steps. The lion judges not the pussycat, eh? Cute. Takes a whole lot more oomph to get a rise out of me, though. Go talk to the raucous one. Tell him I sent you, and he'll set you up for a challenge. Prove yourself worthy fighting my acolytes blindfolded. Then, I'll knock your teeth out.
Figure it's time to prove yourself. Let's get it done. Well, that just may interest our current champion, Murga. She'll want a talk with you herself before she'll assent to any challenge. Watch your words, mind. She takes against you, there'll be no talking yourself into her good graces again. Your call. Not everyone can rise to Murga's levels. She's got enough venom to put a snake to shame. In any case, you're in for a treat, laddie. Better than sweet cream stew on Lucian's day. Who's coming along with you? yourself.
She appraises you, unsmiling.
Nice to see the cub has some claws. You drew blood. Enough to know you're alive. But you removed your blindfold in the arena. You failed my challenge. Now I'll never taste my victory in your blood. Try your luck somewhere else, ducky.
Nice show out there. You're smouldering. That's Margaret's call. I abide by her ye. Nice show out there. You're smouldering. That's Margaret's call.
Need your hand squeezed some more. Plenty.
Watch out for Murga, stranger. She's a formidable fighter.
Did you know our arena champion's a bloody cheat, stranger? Murga tricked me and bit off my...
Who in their right mind would keep a Voidwoken locked up like this?
Need your hand squeezed some more. Plenty of lonely drinkers upstairs. Thank you.
Who in their right mind would keep a Voidwoken locked up like this?
You're back. What's on? Marga ain't among the living no more. A shame it is. Strong enough to carry an ox on her back and still goad you to throw on another. Slow that gallop, troll jockey. What makes you think I should let you do that? Sorry, but not under my watch. You might go pissing in the market at high noon, but I gotta go by the rule. You're back. Marga ain't among the... Slow that gallop. All right, buddy. Color me convinced. Excited, even. Seriously, this ought to be good. You're only getting the one shot, so keep your eye on the prize. Who's coming with you? prepare yourself.
The dwarf bounces up and down with glee, then catches himself and clears his throat. He bows before you.
Extraordinary, son, just extraordinary. The spirit of the One has yet to settle, but it hovers near. It knows your great feat. I feel the glow. Ain't just praise you're earning, though, giving you this key, too. It's an arena champ tradition. Takes you to treasure, it does, and only a champ can survive that journey.
The dwarf bellows out to all within earshot.
I proclaim thee the champion of the Driftwood Arena. Get your gloat on and take a swig of ale. Hell, take a dozen. We'll be singing for years to come of the great human Void Slayer. Impressive. Dare say the spirit of the One stronger in you than anyone else I've seen. Even Murga.
No go. Not now, at least.
Seems I can't use that right now. Seems I can't use that right now.
Thank you. garbage.
Thank you.
Kibbs at war.
My good sir, I see that you accompany no other than His Royal Majesty, the Red Prince. I have a message for him of quite vital importance, if you'd be so kind.
Of course he'll be so kind. Speak freely, kinsman.
Directions, my lord. I was bid to send you to none other than Bramos the Wanderer. He was waiting for you here, my prince. But...
He looks around the hazy room with hasted eyes.
The House of Shadows stirs. The Honorable Bramos sensed them closing in. He had no choice but to flee from Driftwood. A little ways east he went, in search of safety, to an encampment of paladins. You will find him there, Majesty. And with that, I have told my tale.
Indeed I am. We will follow your directions. You have my thanks, kinsman.
Prince of princes, I am humbled and grateful.
He bows deeply before the Red Prince, as reverently as one would before a god.
The House of Shadows stirs. An ominous phrase. It's as if I can feel the onset of night. Perhaps. But you must realize that until a short while ago, the very existence of the House of Shadows was a mystery to us. If this thing of darkness steps into the light, it must be desperate. And desperate means dangerous. You still stand by me then, despite us being targeted by such a formidable foe? That is quite admirable, I must say. Onward, then. Let them strike when they may. We shall be ready for them.
What do you want? Boss is busy. Good. Boss could use some good news. Listen up. Don't waste his time. These are explosive times. Be respectful.
Easy. Marla's one of us.
Brought you up from girl to woman, Marla, like you was my own. This.
He lifts his right arm, showing a white bandage beneath his ribs. A wet red spot shows through.
This ain't the thanks I expected. Who sent you?
The formidable dwarf slams his fist on the side table. You hear a loud crack.
Enough! Do you know they killed Anhar? Do ya? Start talking sense or I'll take that tongue right out of your mouth and fry it for supper. Barnt, Cade, get her to talk or bleed her out. She ain't one of mine anymore.
His sneer travels from the restrained dwarf to you.
And you. You better have a damn good reason for coming here.
You're making this much harder than it needs to be.
Brave lad. Waltzing in here now. I hope for your sake you've got good news for me.
Tell the truth now. Who was he that said?
You came into my house, bub. Not the other way around.
He winces loudly and holds a hand to the bandage on his side. The large red spot in its center has grown larger and wetter.
Leave a wound alone and it'll patch itself right up. Longer it takes, the less likely you'll let it happen again. Sure I did. I lay my trust where I shouldn't have. Won't happen again. So, how'd you make it out of Fort Joy? I've got to say I'm impressed. I love a good story. Here's one I heard lately. A group of strangers landed on the beaches outside town. Meister Siva's people. You one of her little seekers? Chasing down Godwoken and begging them to save us all. That's so.
He leans back and narrows his eyes, looking you up and down.
You know, the Order's been going on about Godwoken for an eon now. Voidwoken's still lurking, though, and they're still hauling folks off to the Joy. So if you are who you say you are, what's the point of you? Ah, I should have guessed. I could help you. But last I heard, you was working for the Magisters. Big shots at the boats. Now, why in the name of all the Earths would I help a worm like that? What a load of shite. Siva's got an eye for talent, though. Maybe there's something to you. I reckon I could help you out, depending on what you can do for me.
You're making this much harder than it needs to be.
Everything costs something round here. Only question is how much you're willing to pay.
He gestures towards the bandage across his side.
Had a bit of family trouble lately. My girl Marla got it in her head to come after me with a short blade. That ain't like Marla. Ain't like her to pull the silent treatment either. Something's going on. And wouldn't you know it, that blade she used wasn't any normal bit of steel. Belonged to another of my people. Guy's name is Mordus. Bit of a loner, but smart as hell. I sent a few guys to go check on him, see if he knew what had got into Marla, but no one can find him. I'd like a word with the guy. Glad you see it that way. No one's seen him in a good few. I've got some people checking out his house near the tavern now, though.
Tell them I sent you, and they'll let you know what they've found. Truth is, they might be glad to see you. Reckon a sorcerer will have better luck finding one of their own. Well, like I said, Maldus is a special guy. A sorcerer, matter of fact. Maybe even one of the ones Seaver's after. If there's something you want to find out from him, you might want to ask before I have my word with him. Here, you can take this off my hands. More suited to your kind, really. Good luck.
I heard rumor Maudus